Hey guys, it's Prissy and welcome back for another video. As you can tell by the title, I am doing a protective style today. My hair has been growing, like for me, it's been growing so much during this quarantine. So I have been wanting to do some protective styles to try to keep it growing so that by December I can get a cute little blowout. So if you guys are interested in this cute little red ponytail that I did, girl, look at this. Oh my goodness. If you guys are interested in this ponytail, then just keep watching. So my hair has been freshly washed and conditioned, and I just combed it straight back for bed. Now, I thought I was going to be able to get away with putting it just, you know, into like an easy ponytail from this stage. But girl, after I started combing it out, I soon realized that, sis, your hair is just too thick for all that. So I ended up having to blow it out a little just so it was easier to manage. I started by separating my hair into sections. I created four manageable sections with the hair, and I started by prepping the back area first. Like I told you guys earlier, my hair is so thick, so I'll be applying a generous amount of the Murray's molding paste. I apply it all around the first section, and then I even part that section and apply a little more product in between. I then comb and smooth the paste throughout my hair. Now that the hair in the back has been prepped, I'll move on to my next section and repeat the process until the entire back of my hair is ready for a ponytail. I'll be using my brush to gather all of the hair in the back of my head. And this one is a hard bristle brush, guys. My hair would just laugh at a soft bristle. I also applied some spritz right before brushing just to ensure all of those flyaways stay put. Now on to tackle the front portion of my hair. I always like to comb through the hair before adding the product. This quick detangling ensures you have minimal kinks and knots in your hair. Apply paste, spritz, and then brush the product onto the hair. At this point, we want to combine the front section with the back section to create one big ponytail. Because I'm not a huge fan of my widow's peak, I went ahead and shaved that off before attempting to lay these edges. As for my edges, EBIN 24-hour edge tamer has me covered. I pulled some of my thinner edges out with the tail of my comb because I really don't have any baby hairs. I mean, let's face it, I haven't been a baby in a long time. One thing about my hair that I do struggle with is laying my edges. It's not something that I do often, so it is a bit of a challenge for me. Finally got those edges done, so I'm going to add more spritz right before I wrap my hair to set the ponytail. I like using the wrap strips and then top it off with a silk scarf just to let this ponytail set. baby. This edge control is so good. I mean, do y'all see my edges?
I like that. I like that.
Oh, I like this stuff. I like this. I felt my nape needed a little attention, so I had Babe remove some of the excess hair and clean it up a little. After comparing the hair to mine, I soon realized it was a little more on the fluorescent side. I'm so glad I had a pack of red and 1B, so I kind of mixed that in to tone down the brightness of that red pack just a bit. Once I had the hair mixed to my liking, I added a hair tie to the middle and began to braid the hair. I used my doorknob as a holder while I braided the hair. After the braid is done, I'm going to add a couple of rods to the end. I want the ends to be curly, so I'll dip them in hot water so the curl can set. I'm also going to use my scissors to cut any flyaways and make the braid look a little neater. Now I'm going to place the braid onto my hair and secure it with a few bobby pins. I also used a loose piece of braiding hair to wrap around the base of the ponytail. This will help with concealing your real hair. So at this point, my hair is pretty much done. I do like to go in and stretch the braid out so that it's a little more relaxed and loose, but this hair is done, guys. Alright guys, so I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to give me a thumbs up. Also, comment below and tell me where I can get some red hair to kind of match this a little bit better so I ain't got to do all that blending. You know, refer some good hair sites down below in the comments. And as always guys, I will see you in my next video. Bye bye. Y'all, you can't tell me nothing right now, okay? You can't tell me nothing. Like, I feel like a different person today. So maybe I should have introduced myself as somebody else. I don't know.